Let's put up the pictures here. You have a departmentally charged individual who has been fired. The Memphis PD has fired Preston Hemphill following the brutal beating and death of Tyre Nichols. Now remember, we've reported on this since day one. We posed the questions, why did they try to hide this particular officer? There's a lot of background here. Hemphill, who's obviously a white officer, was present during the initial traffic stop on January 7th, where Nichols was pulled out of his car, pushed to the ground, shot with a stun gun, and beaten brutally to death. Hemphill, who had been suspended last month, and by the way, they suspended him secretly, we were not aware, was departmentally charged and terminated. Finally, Friday, the department said, adding that an investigation into other police officers was ongoing. The department declined to comment further on Saturday. Now remember, someone from Memphis who works for the Memphis city government told me directly that 12 officers, roughly 12, were actually at the scene. They were down with the program. They knew what was going to happen. They knew what was happening. Right now, we know of 7. Hemphill is 6, but there are 7 that we are aware of. They are still saying more will be investigated. I think cops who had no presence at that scene were involved in cover-up as well. I think they may have been contacted prior to the engagement with the parent, where these cops lied to the parents about what happened to their son. I think those officers are under investigation as well. Just my hunch. There's more. So Hemphill gets suspended, all right? The department declined to comment further about this particular investigation. An investigation showed that Officer Hemphill had, and I quote, violated multiple departmental policies, including personal conduct, truthfulness, and compliance with regulations on using stun guns, the department said in a statement Friday evening. Can I remind everyone that what they are describing is likely a lie or multiple lies on an official document? Well, that's illegal. Impeding an official police investigation, that's obstruction of justice. And both of those charges also warrant the charge of violation for oath of office. That is a felony. Why has he not been charged with these elements, at least transparently? We are not aware. There's more. The Shelby County, Tennessee District Attorney's Office has also been considering charges for Hemphill, according to a statement post to its Facebook accounts. Considering charges. Hemphill wore the body camera that provided video of the first police confrontation with Nichols. In the video, Hemphill can be seen using a taser on Mr. Nichols. Later, a voice on the body cam that seems to be Hemphill's says, and I quote, "I hope they stump his ass." Still no charges that we are aware of. After Nichols escaped, Nichols was then chased down near his home by other police officers and brutally beaten. Once again, DA says, hey, we're considering charges. The police have done a move called departmentally charge. That's BS. Let's go ahead and get this jury set up, get the grand jury set up, do a real indictment, make sure it sticks. No issues with constitutionality, et cetera. Put up the 5 cops who were presented to us as the only ones who did this in the beginning. These cowardly SOBs were already relieved of duty. They now have charges, including murder, and they should. Justin Smith, Emmett Martin III, Desmond Mills Jr., Demetrius Haley, and Tadarius Bean. Horrible people, horrible individuals. But please keep in mind, aiding and abetting is also a chargeable offense. As a matter of fact, it is not uncommon. It's the routine thing to do when you are involved in such a heinous crime. The other officers have not been charged with those crimes as anyone else would have who helped kill a human being. There's more. However, his suspension has caused criticism. Let's put up our dear brother, Benjamin Crump. Benjamin Crump made it clear in the beginning of this that there's a problem. He's representing the family. He previously questioned why it took so long for Officer Hemphill's identity to be made public. He tweeted, and I quote, "Why was the white officer involved in the brutal attack of Tyre Nichols shielded and protected?" Let's put up the chief of police. Memphis police chief, they call it CJ, CJ Davis, said at the same time, the five were directly responsible for the physical abuse against Nichols. That quote made it seem as if, remember, this was prior to the video evidence. That quote made it seem as if those five officers were the only killers of Mr. Tyre Nichols. We know that not. We know that's not the case now. Put up the picture of the others who failed in their duty according to their own agency. This happened on Friday. A state medical director board has now suspended the license of two former Memphis Fire Department employees who waited damn near 20 minutes to treat Mr. Nichols. Those medical licenses belong to EMTs Robert Long and Jermichael Sandridge. Michelle Whitaker, the third person terminated over the Nichols case, did not have her license suspended. I don't know why. I would like to have information as to why her license remains intact. But I want you to keep that picture up. I'm going to make a point again. Let's put that picture back up. You have a young white male, you have a young black male, and you have a black female who may be a little bit senior to them. The reason why I bring this up is because all of them obviously operated from the same culture page, not the same culture. This is important to note. They all violated policy according to their employers. They all violated policy. And they violated policy that led to the death of a human being. They did not plan this. They did not coordinate. They do not share a cultural connection, age, race, or gender outside of the culture of their profession. So in the culture of their profession, they believed this was okay. What does that mean? That means you have a cultural problem, not a policy problem. Culture eats policy alive every day of the week. Mr. Mayor, you know a whole lot about city government as a mayor. You know a whole lot about culture as a mayor. Talk to us about this scenario.
I am so glad you ended with the culture point and the cultural page point and making that distinction, because people need to understand, if you have a racist police chief and they can be whatever color you want to, that's not a police department problem. That's actually a mayoral problem in most cities where the mayor hires the police chief. This incriminates more than just the people whose pictures we've seen, people who've been let go. This actually implements all 18,000 police departments across this country, because we know the culture is, regardless of what the policy says, the culture is black men specifically are sport. Killing black men is sport in this country, and less than 1% of officers who's acted that way have been charged criminally and convicted. So we know that these people weren't doing anything out of bounds as it pertains to how American police black men. The idea that you can kill black men or beat this man to death steps away from his home seems like par for the course for these people. If you look at their track record, even though the Memphis department is trying to code it and cover it up, all of them had multiple complaints from citizens about their interactions with these officers. And people are trying to say that those complaints went down as of recently. That's because the murder rate has went up. You've probably been killing people that have been complaining about police, not just in Memphis, but all over this country. So I think when we consider now that police departments were birthed out of slave patrols, and it started in my home state of North Carolina, the first slave patrol became a police department. And then you move on to when they were lynching black people, mostly black men, between 1869 and then the mid 19th century or 20th century, we saw about 3,500 black people killed, right? That's about 41 people per year. But if you look at the rate that black people are killed by cops, you're talking about 271 people per year between 2017 and 2022. So the lynching of black people is culture in this country, regardless of the race, because we know it's acceptable. And America has a high tolerance for black suffering, as we see in everyday policing policy, I should say culture in this country.
Very well said, Mr. Mayor. And I'm glad you brought up the point about policing and the origin of it. I do believe agencies can change. Let me tell you why I believe agencies can change, because they come down to systems and people. Systems and people can change, but you must understand the origin of a thing to understand the nature of a thing. You cannot dismiss the origin of policing being connected to slavery. You cannot dismiss that, because if you do, you will never deal with its true nature.